You're looking live at a watch party in Wallace Annenberg Forum. All eyes are on New Hampshire as the first Democratic primary wraps up. The results are still coming in and the polls are closed. Good evening, I'm Nathan Hyun.
And I'm Genevieve Glass, and we've just learned that Democratic candidate Andrew Yang has dropped out of the presidential race. The 45-year-old entrepreneur had promised to give every American $10,000 a month. And here are the results, with 23% of precincts reporting. Senator Bernie Sanders is the front runner tonight with just over 28% of the votes. He is followed by former South Bend, Indiana Mayor Pete Buttigieg at close to 23%. Amy Klobuchar is in third place with 20% of votes, and Elizabeth Warren has just over 9%, and Joe Biden is in fifth place with just over 9% of votes. We spoke with political expert Bob Shrum to get his predictions for the final vote tally tonight.
Look, I'm not going to tell you what the results are going to be. The polls suggest that Bernie Sanders is going to win, that Pete Buttigieg is probably going to be second, that Amy Klobuchar may have some momentum, although the polls, different polls disagree on that.
We spoke with two political activists at USC. One is with the USC College Democrats. The other is a Bernie Sanders supporter with a Democratic Socialist organization right here on campus.
Since we are the Democrats, we're supporting all of our club members, and a lot of us support different candidates. You know, we have more similarities than differences, and that's what we need to focus on, especially when picking a candidate. And I think just all us Democrats need to come together and support whoever that is gonna be. Say if it is Bernie, which it might be looking like, then we need to come together and support him.
I support Bernie Sanders, so I feel pretty positive, and I feel hopeful after what happened in Iowa. Even if Bernie Sanders doesn't win, I think that a lot of people have been mobilized by his campaign, and will hopefully seek like other entries into like political action.
Next up, Nevada and South Carolina. There, candidates will have to prove just how well they can do in states that are much more diverse than New Hampshire and Iowa.
Right now, there's